Today we're going to cover vapor permeable and impermeable membranes or wraps for the building envelope, where we wrap the inside or and the outside of the building envelope. We're going to talk about the correct ways to install these types of products, but let me put you over to Joseph and we'll talk about the external wraps.
This is a piece of vapor permeable membrane. Usually in our climate down in Melbourne, a more temperate climate, we put this on the outside of the building to replace the traditional sacking. When compared to sacking, this product requires a bit more care during installation, but the performance you get from this product is way superior compared to the sacking product. Traditionally, we always have some problem about moisture and mold in between the building cavity, but with this product properly installed, it can provide a very excellent moisture control inside the building cavity and improve the longevity and the health of your building.
Going back to that, Joseph, the other issue that we're finding when it comes to installing these types of products, where they are installed like sacking, they tend to treat these products like sacking on the inside of the building envelope as well.
Because a lot of the trades, they have not been properly trained and being informed by the professional who specify this type of product. Yep. And that become a major problem for a lot of clients. They know they need to get a better building product, but they're not being installed properly. So at the end of the day, all the money and effort to install and pay for a superior product just gone down the drain.
So it's a complete waste of time to buy it, and then it's a complete waste of time to actually install it for the labor that it takes to do it. So let's cover some of these points now and show you how we sometimes see it installed, and then obviously go over how we want to see it installed so that the product actually works.
This is a junction between the internal partition wall to the external wall. In the traditional construction, this connection here always become a weak point in air leakage. The air from the outdoor the external wall, can easily go into this cavity and go everywhere inside your building. To prevent that from happening, this is a very important trick called a starter strip. This starter strip will be installed before they put in the stud for the internal wall to create a piece of the continuous membrane. One of the key points we always need to remember, and we are going to repeat it over and over and over again, is your building membrane and building wrapping needs to be continuous throughout your internal and external surface. And this is how we deal with the difficult application when there is a junction between internal and external wall with a starter strip.
Okay, we're going to get these guys to put up a piece of internal wrapping, like they're putting up their washing. So they're just going to be stapled up in the corners to just hold it up. There's a really good reason why we shouldn't use staples. When we do an air tightness test on this membrane, especially in depressurization, the pressure within the building envelope will actually start ripping the membrane where the staples actually have been pinned on. So there's a product that you can use instead of staples called Twinette, where you, it's basically a double-sided tape, and you put it on all of the studs.
The issue is here, you're making divots.
Yeah, you make little holes in the corners.
And then if that ever pulls away, you'll have holes.
Yep. When you have millions of staples going through your building envelope, it adds up to quite a significant hole in the building envelope.
This internal vapor impermeable membrane is being installed like the traditional sacking. Typically, we just have an overlap and nothing is being sealed up or taped up. If I'm telling you this is an airtight solution, would you believe me? Just seeing how my hand can go behind. Do you think air cannot penetrate through such a gap? And what's the point of installing this when air, moist air, can just freely pass through here and hit the insulation? And when the air is going into contact with the insulation, it will move slightly towards the outside until it gets to a point it's cold enough, and then it will condensate and soaking wet this insulation. And if you got any kind of dust, paper product in there, they will grow mold. Mold just love that condition, moist with food and right temperature, and they will just flourish inside your building cavity. And this is not what you want to use this product. And we'll get our expert installer to show us how to install it properly.
Okay, so we're gonna finish off this piece that we've installed incorrectly and try to remediate it. So the guys have to put some more staples in to fix it to the battens. With all of these staples as well, because they're gonna start ripping the membrane, especially with the air tightness testing, or just some pressures that might come throughout the building envelope, they have to put some tape over each staple. So now we're gonna put the twinette on each batten. So it's basically a double-sided tape, and the guys will be able to fix the membrane directly to that. In this particular installation, there is no services cavity, so the plaster goes directly on top of the membrane, gets fixed directly on top of it. So now the guys are going to be sealing between the two pieces, top and bottom, which will stop any air leakage that might occur in between the two pieces of wrap. And this is how you actually use these types of products. They need to be installed in an airtight fashion. The top of the membrane is also going to be taped as well. And then we're going to be taping to this little piece that's been put on this internal wall that's coming off the facade. These membranes, there's quite a few of them on the market, and they all need to be treated the same. And what we're talking about today here, it's exactly the same for all of them.
Remember, I told you before, and I'm going to repeat it once again, you need to have a continuous airtight layer all around the house.